Today, I'm going to run through 5 must-have productivity apps for Mac. Number 1 brings back the window snapping features from Windows. If you've ever spent a lot of time on Windows, then you know that you can just grab a window by the title bar and throw it to the side to fill half of the screen, or throw it to the top to fill the whole thing. And you don't have those features on the Mac, unless you download Rectangle. It's free and open source, so anybody can get it. And not only does it have the same gestures with the mouse, but it also has completely customizable keyboard shortcuts. So here you'll see I can just grab this window, throw it to this side, and fill half of the screen instantly. I can grab a window and throw it to the corner, and it'll fill just a quarter of the screen. Or, you know, take it and fill half again. Or I can just grab any window and throw it to the top, and it'll maximize and fill the whole screen. This is really useful if you have a laptop, like maybe the 13-inch MacBook Air, where your screen can get kind of crowded and you just want a clean way to show two windows side by side. Number 2 is a great way to take screenshots and screen recordings on your Mac. It's called CleanShot X. Now, the Mac already has a built-in screenshot feature where you can capture the whole screen, or capture a specific window, or like record a specific portion of the screen, but CleanShot X takes this to a whole nother level. After you set up a screenshot, you can instantly recapture another screenshot with the same parameters. You can go through your setup history, so you can quickly retake the same shot in the same spot with the same settings. You can record any screen recording as a GIF if you want to post it on a website. There's a self-timer feature, so you can hit the button and then you have a few seconds to get something set up just the way you want. And the real kicker is that you can temporarily hide all of your desktop icons, so you don't have to clean up your desktop between every shot. CleanShot X costs $29, and that comes with a year of software updates. Number 3 is Maccy, a really minimal clipboard manager. It's so great, you'll completely forget it's not built into the Mac. Now you can just copy and paste as you normally would, you don't have to do anything special. But if you want to paste like the second or third thing back, you hit Command-Shift-C, and then you can see a full list of your history. You have keyboard shortcuts, 1 through 9, for the first 9 items on the list, or you can just, you know, click with the mouse. It's so fast. So here, you can see I'm copying a bunch of things, one after another, in Safari. And then I switch over to Pages, and I can just paste them, one after another, all in a row. I don't have to bounce back and forth between them. I can copy them all at once, and paste them all at once. Maccy is $9.99 in the App Store, but it's open source, so if you want to build it yourself in Xcode, you can do that for free. Number 4 is a feature that comes built in, and that's called Spotlight. So if you want to, say, open Google Chrome, you can use the gesture to open Launchpad and swipe over and click on the icon. Or if you have it pinned to your dock, you can go down there and click on it. But by far, the fastest way to open apps on the Mac is with Spotlight. You just do Command Space and type the first few letters and it's open. It's that fast. Command Space, first few letters, enter, there you go. Spotlight, of course, is built into every Mac, so you don't have to do anything. Number 5 is for time tracking with Toggle. If you've never used time tracking before, it's really easy. You just type in what you're working on, give it a category, and start a clock. So if you're writing or coding or studying and you hit a snag and you just get that impulse to just switch to something easy like reading Twitter or Mastodon, just knowing that there's a running clock and that you're supposed to be working is really effective, at least for me, on keeping me on task. Let me put it to you this way. I'm the sort of person where I turned off all the activity tracking features on my Apple Watch. They just weren't effective at actually convincing me to exercise. And I can't tell you the last time I even opened the fitness app. But despite that, I wear my watch close to 24/7 just because I want it to have all the data anyways. I never look at the data, I never use the data, I never act on the data, but I just want it to be there and I want it to be accurate. If you find that relatable at all, then you and I are of a kind that will find time tracking very useful. Because sure, I can switch to my RSS feeds and read up on the news, and technically that's working for me. But if Toggle says that I should be writing, then I have to be writing for that data to be accurate. So as you can see, there's a list view of all the things you've been working on today and how long you've been working on them. You can instantly restart any of these timers with just one click. You have a calendar view where you can see a history of your day, and you can add in old data if you maybe forgot to start the timer earlier. Toggle is free for basic personal use, and it has a lot of advanced features like automated reminders in case you forget to start the clock, a Pomodoro timer to remind you to take breaks every once in a while. For some of the more advanced features, you just pay $9 a month. So those are my productivity tips for the Mac. You can find links to everything I talked about and an article version of this in the video description. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.